We all get some kind of tumour at some time, but our immune systems usually recognise it and kill it. It's called tumour surveillance. To be suffering from cancer or a tumour growing, it means that those cancer cells have escaped being seen by your immune system. But we discovered that there's an old drug called prochlorperazine. In Australia, it's called Stemetil. And people take it at low concentrations for travel sickness, but it has a side effect where it can actually stop that endocytosis process. And so what we do is we deliver that old drug, but really high concentrations by IV. And for about 4 to 5 hours, the target of the anti-cancer drugs gets stuck on the tumour cell, and then the drug can bind it and the immune system gets activated. The drug's kind of putting a big flag on the tumour cell to say we're here, and then the natural killer cells can come in and kill it. And really all we're doing is playing Lego with the drugs and the tumours to put everything in the right place at the right time so that the tumour cells can die.
So we found that the combination not only cleared the tumours in the models that we were using, but when we tried to reintroduce the tumours back into those models, back into those animals, they were protected, and the immune systems of the mice were able to prevent the tumours from growing without any further treatment from us. I mean, we had 100% of our mice were protected from tumour rechallenge.
It's exciting because we see in humans a way of changing the cell behaviour that allows antibody treatments to work better, potentially improving the immune response to cancers. It's one of our dreams. So something that you can translate into better outcomes for people.
It was very important to combine basic science with preclinical work, which has been now translated into clinic.
So the next step is going to be the exciting step, and that is the step where we are giving the appropriate doses to people in order to assess the response to treatment. So this is proving that it does work.
The data that we are presenting in this paper are opening a completely new field of therapeutic intervention for cancer patients.
There's 10 years of research in this paper. This was a huge team of people who helped me. They all kept open minds because this is a really weird idea, and they all just kept looking at the data and looking at the science and just followed the results, which has been amazing.